Welcome to Access to Experts podcast, where business success secrets are revealed from world-class experts. And now your host, Debbie Allen.
Hello and welcome to the show. I'm Debbie Allen, your host of Access to Experts, and I'm an avid reader. I'm always learning new things, and when I found out and met Tom Poland, I had to have him on my show. So let me give him a formal introduction as I bring him in here. Tom Poland is a multiple best-selling author specializing in generation of lead generation for coaches and consultants all over the world. He started and sold numerous businesses over the last 39 years. He's younger than you imagine he is. He started as a baby, right? And he has generated millions, $20 million in revenue with companies that he's worked with. And he says he's voluntarily married and lives and works from his home where he sits on the white sand beach next to the blue ocean at Little Castaways Beach in Australia. I love Australia. So Tom, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Debbie. Privileged to be here.
And I have absolutely been enjoying your wonderful book here, Marketing with Webinars. I want to talk about that with you today because anybody can do this, you know, and you have built a worldwide name. Like, you know, you're famous all over the world, if you don't even realize it. And he knows it. And so by sitting in your home office, be having financial freedom, doing what you want, and doing it mostly with webinars and building a list and then showing other people how to do that.
That's it. Yep.
So cool. I mean, as long as the internet doesn't go down, we're all happy. We're all
that's right. I'll figure out how to use smoke signals or something.
Exactly. From the other side of the world. So, you know, how did it start out you being a multiple best-selling author as far as, you know, have you had books before this and this is your newest one?
Well, my first book I wrote, I was very proud of it, 103,000 words, and it sold in its tens. And when I say it sold in its tens, I don't mean tens of thousands. I mean, my mother bought a box for the golf club friends. Look, my son, the author. Yeah, mum, you just bought like 90% of all the books I ever sold. So it did not do well, I have to say, although it's still my favorite book. But that's sort of a humorous aside, really. Took me a long time to figure out that, you know, what marketing was all about, which is effectively finding people already looking for what you've got.
That is killer. I love that. Exactly. Rather, ding, ding, ding.
Right. Well, so selling is convincing people that what you've got that, you know, they should buy, and marketing is finding the people that are already looking for what you've got. And so, you know, how that relates to a book that sold in its tens is that, first of all, you've got to figure out what people are looking for, because if they ain't looking for what I've got, it's going to be really hard to market it. And that sort of is a nice sort of segue into why, you know, why marketing webinars, how did I become this person who specializes in lead generation. And that really goes back to me being a 23-year-old management consultant, which is a pretty stupid thing to do, to try and compete against PricewaterhouseCoopers as a 23-year-old. You know, you're still sort of wet behind the ears. And back in the day, Debbie, and not that you're old enough to know this, but when you had a business, you had to have a real office, you know, bricks and mortar.
Right.
You'd have some sitting behind a cute thing. We used to call them typewriters, you know, clunk, 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 and business cards and letterhead. So basically you had overhead. And so I used to wake up every Monday morning feeling unemployed, going, my God, where's the next client coming from? So it didn't take me long to figure out, it didn't really matter how good a service or a product I have, if I couldn't market it, I was going to be broke, and, you know, the house was going to get sold and my wife would divorce me and all the rest of it. And I'd turn to drinking and end up living in a gutter. At least that's what went through my brain.
That was a lot. That was like the first minute.
Yeah, that was like,
that's a true entrepreneurial thinking here.
And so I wanted to crack the lead generation thing. You know, I got obsessed with it. And I ended up cracking it in the form of events. I was running events because I tried everything, radio advertising, billboards. You know, at one stage we had a guy booked to do sign writing and we canceled it, probably a good idea. But we tried everything to make the darn thing work. We discovered the very best thing was getting suspects, because you couldn't really call them prospects, but getting people we suspected might be interested in what we're doing into a room. and me talking and sharing and workshopping and seminaring and all the other things for a couple of hours, and then handing out feedback forms, say, if you want this sort of stuff in your life or your business, pick the form and we'll have a chat. We really discovered events very early on. In the old days, we'd send out 10,000 direct mail letters, we'd buy a list, we'd send out tickets and say, hey, congratulations, you've scored some free tickets and so on. And whatever we think of that ethically, that's what we did, you know, for my sins, that's what we did sort of thing. And we got rooms packed, and I did over 500 seminars and workshops, which is a lot, you know.
Oh, that's a lot. I know, I've been doing them for 15 years, and it's a lot of details. You know, it's the details are really in filling the room, which is the...
That's exactly right. And once you've got there, you've still got to perform well. But if you don't get in the room, it doesn't matter how good your performance is. So that then, I sold one of those businesses. The last business I sold was back in 2007 or 2008, I think. And I was sitting twiddling my thumbs, and I got this email from someone saying, hey, we've got this new thing called a webinar. And having run so many seminars and being in love with the World Wide Web, I thought, oh, that's clever. A webinar. Now it's kind of passe. So I got up at 3 o'clock in the morning, because it was run out of New York or somewhere. And, you know, in Australia, that's like 3 o'clock in the morning here. And sat through the most boring presentation.
With PowerPoint,
death by bullet point.
Bullet points. Bang. Yeah.
Yeah. Monotone.
There's a reason for that. That you want to die. You want the bullets.
Yeah, that's right. Give me the bullet already. But I went back to sleep and I woke up and I thought, I think this thing's got legs. You know, if I could do what I used to do with seminars and workshops and not have to fly and not have to drive, and not everyone else didn't have to drive and fly and, you know, these days go through security and wear masks and whatever else we have to do. If I could do that and not leave home, wow, that would be amazing. Because basically I am an introvert. I don't get out unless my wife dragged me out. So that's what we did. And so that started me down the path of this. Let's see if we could take the event world that we had considerable success in and transfer that online. So hence marketing webinars.
Yeah, you were a pioneer in that. You know, it's like, you know, that, and that's what everybody's doing now. It's like they're all jumping online because, you know, right. That's the only place to be. And you've already been there. You don't have to pivot. You're already doing it and teaching people how to do it. You've just probably pivoted to different clients that are looking for you, as of more corporate clients. And now everybody doing it, coaches, consultant, entrepreneurs, experts online right now.
And one of the questions I often get is, aren't people over webinars? I mean, attendance rates are going down. People kind of, webinars, no big deal. It used to be novelty. And the answer is absolutely not. I mean, if you're doing them, if you're offering crap webinars, yeah, they're not going to work. But, you know, one of the big issues is, where do you get the audiences from? And having got the audiences, how do you motivate them to want to attend and so on? There's all sorts of stick bonuses and reminders. And people send out SMS, so on. But you know, go back to what we said earlier. What good marketing does is it gives people an offer they're already looking for. It gets that, finds those people. So if you have a webinar that people are passionately interested about, as represented in the title, they register and they attend. Doesn't matter what you do with SMSs or stick bonuses or 10 reminders in the last hour and that sort of, it's just window dressing. It's just trying to compensate for a poor title, essentially.
Right. No, it's the titles that get you. I mean, I've already done three already. I know it's 9 a.m. on the next day over there, but I've already done three. It was like my training day today. Wow. But they got me, because there's so many choices, but they got me with the title. And then now the title has the subtitle and clever stuff. You know, if it works for what the title is, but it's like, what's the new things? What's happening? What is that solution to the biggest problems that are going on?
Yeah, absolutely. And that's, again, coming back to the title's got to be something that your ideal client's already looking for. So when they see it, first of all, it gets cut through, because we all get 300, 400, 500 emails a day. And we all do this. We all go through the email invitations, whatever they are. We go delete, 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 delete. Oh, that's interesting. That's from someone who I respect, who normally offers value. So I'll have a look at that. And then if the title, whether it's a giveaway or a webinar, whatever it is, if it's something we have a passionate interest about, we're gonna explore and go further.
Most definitely. And it's one of the best ways to sell. I mean, you know, putting your message out there. You know, I know a lot of these webinars are constantly selling. So the word webinar has gotten a bad name. That's true. You know, people are using masterclasses or other names like that too, because they've been pitched ineffectively. Would you say that you, every time you do a webinar, you make an offer, or you're giving a lot of content away in between? How do you really manage that?
Yeah. Well, the first thing is I'm a great believer in karma marketing, as in reap what you sow karma, not as in quieter karma, but karma marketing. So, you know, give a lot of value. Essentially, you can afford to forget what the old school marketers, including me, used to say, which was tell them what to do, but not how to do it. Give them everything. And I figured this out because the people that are smart and have the money will want to work with you to implement, because they'll know that they're going to implement much more effectively, much faster, and it'll be money very well spent because they'll get a return on that investment. So the smart people with money will want to work with you. The people who don't have the money, you should help them as best you can. And the people who are arrogant and think they can do it all themselves, you don't want to work with them. You know, you right. can't teach them anything. So I just give away the farm basically on the webinar. So it doesn't matter which category people fit into, they're going to get some value and they're going to walk away happy, sort of thing. So yes, there's always a call to action because they are marketing webinars. I don't present them as a free training webinar because it's not. Mm-hmm. It's a demonstration. And I learned from a previous business when I was early 30s, I had a software business, competed against a guy called Bill Gates. He did a little better than me. But you know, we were in software development. And I learned very early on in that business that people love the demonstration. The demonstration is somewhere where you get to sit back and look at someone else strut their stuff. You know, maybe they trip over, maybe they do great, but you get to sit back and you get to see this demonstration. Whereas a training, sounds like I'm going to have to work hard here. So it's a little subtle repositioning, but it's also a very direct and very honest and transparent value proposition. If you want to come to this webinar, it's going to be a demonstration of how I work with my clients in 27 cities around the world to show them how they generate a weekly flow of high quality and value client inquiries.
But so there's then always you're sharing your screen. Let me get this right. So you're sharing your screen and taking them around going, okay, here's how you'd market your webinar on LinkedIn or whatever. You know, you're showcasing them. Like, yeah, if somebody's sitting across from the desk from you.
It's a PowerPoint presentation. Yeah. And you're doing, I mean, I do mine a little differently. I'm standing in front, like a weather person standing in front of a big screen. But that's just because I love technology and I got bored, you know. So I bought the 75-inch 4K color screen, had it delivered to my house. I thought, now what am I going to do with it? So anyway, you've got it all set up. So it's really cool. But our clients just use PowerPoint screen share so people can see what's on their screen. There's a set sequence that all of my clients use. I call it a persuasion sequence. And it leads people through from the title through to identifying that the audience is in the right place and here's how they're going to benefit by sticking around. Credibility building for the present presenter, my client, proof of how well the system works and so on. We're very clear right at the front. There's going to be details about a program or about a service or how you can go to the next step at the end. If you want to stick around for that, then we've hopefully earned that right by giving you so much interesting value. You're still here at the end when we do that.
And that's just being honest. I mean, because it's like if you're trying to, you know, tell people that it's like, okay, we're just going to get information and then you're not going to, you know, you're not going to get an offer. You're just going to hear and it's a class. Right. Well, I mean, anybody knows we're selling stuff, but we don't want to, you have to do it in a way that isn't pitchy, that's teaching, but also gives you the credibility of the case studies and all of that kind of weaved in, correct?
Absolutely. And you got to, when you're doing a case study, you've got to provide relevance. So I'm showing you these three client results so that you're going to pay attention when I show you how it all works.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to understand this is very powerful, and that's why I'm showing it to you. Yes, at the end of the presentation, I will also make an offer, and it's going to help with that as well. So this very open, very transparent, this is what I'm doing. This is why I'm doing it. This is how you're going to benefit from it, and this is how I'm going to benefit from it. So people say it's like a breath of fresh air. Someone's finally being freaking honest. You know, Seth Godin, Mark wrote that.
Yeah, that's true.
You wrote so many wonderful little books. All marketers are liars. And I was very offended when I saw that title.
No.
but certainly a lot of marketers exaggerate. So when we present our demonstration, when someone listening to this presents their webinar or their, you know, be honest, be open, be transparent. Here's how you're going to benefit. Here's how I'm going to benefit. You're good with that? Great. Let's carry on, because that will immediately differentiate you from, you know, 90% of the other people, certainly the hucksters that they've heard, and they can relax. And I go, our whole Westminster justice system is founded on the idea of reasonableness. Does it sound reasonable? You know, beyond reasonable doubt. So when you explain something, credit people with enough common sense to go, yeah, that sounds fair. That sounds reasonable. And in doing so, you give them a sense of empowerment, and you don't have to try and pull the wool over anyone's eyes. And that way we all get to sleep well at night and hopefully enter into, because if there's any duplicity or any deceptiveness right at the start, like at the marketing end of a relationship, you have to ask yourself, is it going to get any better once I pay them some money?
Yeah, it's going to get a nightmare. And the answer
is probably not. You know, yes. We wondered if Donald Trump, love him or hate him, was going to suddenly get presidential when he became president. What a shock. He kept being Donald Trump.
Yeah, and he's an entrepreneur. That's like, yeah, exactly, right, exactly.
Yeah. And whatever you think of the guy, he was true to himself.
Mm-hmm.
And so if we have the experience of a presenter or a webinar and we feel like that, trying to, you know, be less than transparent, less than honest, it's probably going to continue after you pay the money. So as a presenter, someone listening to this, what I'm doing is I'm encouraging you to be open book. I had a question on a webinar the other day, case in point. Please explain to me how your webinar method is different to the other thousands that are out there.
True.
My answer?
Good question.
I got no idea.
You haven't listened next to question.
How would I know? I mean, I was being a bit facetious.
Well,
but
you could just say, you know, if it sucks after 10 minutes, just leave, right? And if
that's
I'm still
what
like,
I should have said.
If you think I'm smart and maybe a little funny and entertaining.
Yeah.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, just relax, take a chill pill, have some fun while you're doing it.
Yeah, I was on one this morning and I had no idea it was 3 hours. You know, it was like, and it was like, yeah, I signed up for 3 in 1 day, right? And then he said something like, we'll be here together for 3 hours. And there was multiple presenters, but it was really, you know, I stayed on longer than I probably would have just because he was engaging and humorous and they had, you know, other things going on. But yeah, when I heard 3 hours, I was like, okay, saying this isn't happening. And then I think it was kind of becoming a pitch fest because it was like he was making his offer. When I saw that and I saw there's 3 more people, I'm like having a webinar with pitch, you know, as a pitch fest, which if you're listening to this, you know what a pitch fest is. Come to the old seminar days where one speaker after the next is speaking on a little bit of a content of some expertise and then making an offer and it goes on and on. So yeah, let's switch the subject a little bit because, you know, I think that a lot of people when they're starting out is they want to do the webinar just to build their list, or they say, I can't do the webinar yet because I don't have a list. So they kind of go hand in hand. You have to get started somewhere along the way. So, yeah, I mean, I know you have a kind of a contrary view of, you know, your purpose of growing an email list and doing that through webinars. So tell us a little bit about that because that's a big topic.
Yeah, so I set out growing an email list thinking that it was a really good strategy to market my stuff to, and it's a traditional thinking, it's perfectly understandable. But what I discovered is that I should be building my list around a strategy and not building the strategy around the list.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that's of significance because if I use my list to market great free content for someone else, say once a week, let's say 50 weeks of the year, they reciprocate and market my cool free stuff, in this case, a webinar or a free book or whatever it is, to their email list. Now, if you think about that, I get a multiplier factor of, I mean, I can email to my list and promote something of mine probably once every 90 days. Any more than that, they're going to get sick of it. So that's 4 times a year, right?
Right.
So, and even then there's a lower diminishing return. Now the list keeps getting new subscribers, which is nice and so on, but still it's a very limited opportunity. But they're really happy for me to carefully curate, say, I don't know, Debbie Allen's great offer and send it out to them. And they're grateful for that. And I literally get emails saying, hey, thanks for the offer to have a look at Debbie's stuff. It was really cool. I appreciate it. So now I'm marketing 50 other partners' free cool stuff to my email list. And by the way, I started with an email list of 8 people. So don't think you have to have a big list to start, right?
And they all want books.
Yeah, so I could market to my list 4 times a year. I can still do that. But I suddenly have a multiplier factor of 50-fold when I switch my strategy from promoting my cool free stuff to promoting other people's cool free stuff. So now I get access to 50 email lists a year. Wow.
Yeah, wow.
And versus, say, 4 times accessing my own list, which I can still do anyhow. So that's what I mean. If you build your email list around a strategy, so when people subscribe, they should get an email straight off the bat saying, hey, looks like you've just signed up for one of our webinars or signed up for one of our free offers. Cool. You know, now you're on our list. Here's what you can expect. We'll send you every single week, you know, sometimes a couple of times a week, carefully curated content, which you think we think is going to be quite helpful for you in the main. If you don't like that idea, please just click here. So we put that unsubscribe link above the fold, make it really easy for people to go, oh, I don't want that being off the list. But if you do like it, here's an example of what you can expect, blah, 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 bang.
Perfect.
So we're building the list around the strategy that you are going to get a lot of emails from us, but, you know, just if you don't like that, just unsubscribe.
And Tom, you're the very first person I've ever heard say it that way. And it makes so much sense. You know, Tom and I met through a mutual mastermind that we belong to, JVMM. And so it's all about joint venture partners that help us, you know, build the list and introduce each other. And I know as myself, I'm always hiring other experts, and I'm always on other people's, you know, lessons or classes. And I'm the one, the first one to buy, because I'm always like, if they have anything that's new, it's like, if I can learn a little bit more, right? And so, yeah, it's very powerful having that, because if they're like-minded, now you're not just building your list. So when you're listening to this call, it's not about just having an email list, it's having the right email list with a strategy. So having those right partners, that's going to be a key, most definitely. So I'm loving your book, absolutely loving it. Marketing with webinars, get new clients in 1 hour per month. Love that is killer right there, right? So, you know, marketing with seminars, conferences, trade shows, pretty much any business can do this, less than an hour a month. Okay. So, you know, delivering it. And once you do it, once you get comfortable with it, it's really not that hard, you know, to do it. So tell us a little bit more about how we can stay in touch with you, Tom. I know we can go grab a copy of your book on Amazon, but really going to your webinars and seeing what you're doing and learning what you've done for clients.
Well, that's probably not a bad idea is come along and have a look and see how I present and swipe and deploy. So, leadgendemo.live is where folks can go and register, because we run these once a month, you know, first Wednesday every month, typically 4 or 5 p.m. Eastern, I think it is. So they can go to leadgendemo.live and register, and they can also get a free copy of the book, gettomsfreebook.com. If you want it on Kindle or Amazon, paperback, you can get Amazon, of course, but if you just want a PDF, you're happy with that, gettomsfreebook.com. So there's two resources people can go to get bucket loads of value on how we're doing this and how our clients are doing it.
Well, I really appreciate you being here. I mean, there's so much more that we can learn about it, but if you're not doing webinars, or you're doing webinars and you're not getting sales, you're not getting more leads, you're not getting prospects that are turning into sales. I mean, or you want to double and triple that, Tom's definitely the go-to person for it. And he knows a thing or two. So I'm so glad I got to introduce you to my audience. And thanks so much, Tom, for being here. And we'll stay in touch and give you more information. And maybe we'll be doing something together, promoting you online as well to my list.
Looking forward to it. Thanks for the opportunity, Debbie. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Tom. Have a great day.
Thanks for listening to Access to Experts podcast with Debbie Allen, the expert of experts. You can also watch our podcast videos at debbieallen.tv. For more information about your host, visit us at www.debbieallen.com. Remember to subscribe.